Welcome to this practice of Yoga Nidra. And for the next 15 minutes or so, there's nothing else to do. Yeah, nowhere else to be. Nobody else to please. To be here, to be on the ground. To be aware of your body on the ground. To be aware of your breath is enough. To be in your body, breathing, and just letting your attention follow my voice is enough. So just letting all of your awareness settle into your physical form, this incredible body of yours, however it is, in this moment, on your mat, in the position that you've placed it in, your amazing physical body, and feeling it welcome on the earth, imagining your physical body almost like a little stone nestled into the earth, and the edges of the earth rise up to just hold the edges of the stone. And just as the stone rests nestled in the earth, your body rests. And as you breathe out, there's a sense of ease right at the end of the out-breath. Maybe even a sense of weight you become aware of as you breathe out. And that sense of weight is an invitation to settle a little more deeply. An invitation to rest heavily now on the earth. Whole body resting on the earth. Feeling the weight of the back of the head, any supports underneath it, and feeling the ground. And feeling the head a little heavy on the ground. And breathing out, let it settle more fully. Let it rest. And as the weight of the head finds the ground, there's a lightness and a spaciousness that moves in around the jaw and the mouth. An ease around the throat. A little spaciousness between the shoulder blades. Maybe you can even sense the space between the shoulder blades and the ground. Sensing the weight of the shoulders heavy on the earth. Sensing the arms from the shoulders to the elbows, from the elbows to the wrist, palms and the fingertips. Sensing the shoulders and the arms heavy on the ground. And as you breathe out, allowing that sense of weight, those resting shoulders and arms to deepen. And then awareness of the back, of the right side of the back, of the left side of the back, and of the spine. And maybe there's even a sense of space around the lower back where maybe part of the back doesn't meet the earth. And there's a lightness there. But then also sensing the points of contact with the other parts of the back and the earth, and feeling the weight of the left and right side of the back and the spine. And as you breathe out, allowing that weight to settle deeply into the earth, to nestle down. And then awareness of the pelvis and the weight of the pelvis held by the ground. And on the next breath out, is it possible to give away a little more of that weight? Pelvis rests. And then the legs, from the hip bones to the knees, from the knees to the ankles, and the feet, soles of the feet to the tips of the toes. Noticing the spaces around and under the legs, where there's a sense of lightness and maybe no contact with the earth. And then becoming aware of the weight of the legs, the feet and the toes, points of contact. And as you breathe out, allowing the legs and the feet to rest into those points. So imagining the whole body now, sensing all of the points of contact with the earth, and as if you are a beautiful heavy stone resting on the earth, as you breathe out, the whole body settles, deepens, rests. And moving the awareness from the resting body into the heart space, just behind the breastbone. A familiar space or an unfamiliar space. Either way, it doesn't matter. Just letting the light of your attention just come to be here for a moment. As you take a few comfortable, easy breaths in this resting body. And then maybe tuning into the vastness of this space. As if it were the most beautiful beach laid out in front of you. Just the right time of year, just the right temperature, this beautiful beach. And as you gaze down at the floor, at the ground, you see a wonderful pebble nestled in the earth. And you can pick up the pebble and hold it in your hands in your imagination. Imagine holding this pebble in your hands in your heart space. And it's as if the pebble has this deep quality of peacefulness about it. And as you gaze upon the pebble, a sense of peacefulness comes alive in all of you. And you imagine how amazing it would be to feel peaceful in your body, peaceful in your heart, and peaceful in your mind. How amazing it would be. And then we take that deep quality of peacefulness, that ease, gentleness and comfort that comes from that peacefulness on a little journey around the landscape of our body, as if our whole body was that incredible beach. And we'll plant little stones of peacefulness around the body. Moving up to the space above the crown of the head. Space between the eyebrows, space between the collarbones, and inside the right shoulder, and inside the right elbow, and inside the right wrist, and in the palm of the hand, and in the back of the hand, and the tip of the right hand thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger, little finger, right hand thumb, and all the fingers of the right hand alive with a deep sense of peace. Moving back up to the right wrist, planting a little pebble, a little stone, right elbow, right shoulder, and the space between the collarbones. And then moving over to the left and inside the left shoulder, and inside the left elbow, and inside the left wrist, and in the palm of the hand, and in the back of the hand, and the tip of the left hand thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger, little finger. Left hand thumb and all the fingers of the left hand alive with a deep sense of peace. Moving back up to the left wrist, planting a stone there. Left elbow, shoulder, space between the collarbones. And then down to the center of the chest, slowly, mindfully place a stone of peace on the landscape of your body here. And then inside the left rib cage and the center of the chest. And inside the right rib cage and the center of the chest. And then down across the belly into the space between the pubic bones. And then inside the pelvis, carefully, mindfully placing a beautiful stone of peace here. And then to the space in between the pubic bones and over to the right side, inside the right hip, inside the right knee, inside the right ankle, and the sole of the foot, and the top of the foot, and the tip of the right big toe, first toe, second toe, third toe, little toe. Moving back up to the right ankle, a peaceful stone. Right knee, right hip, space between the pubic bones. Inside the pelvis, peaceful stone here. Space between the pubic bones. And then over to the left and inside the left hip. Inside the left knee. Inside the left ankle. And the sole of the foot, and the top of the foot, and then the tip of the left big toe, first toe, second toe, third toe, little toe. Back up to the left ankle, a stone here, left knee, left hip, and the space between the pubic bones, inside the pelvis, and the space between the pubic bones, across the belly and up to the center of the chest, to the space between the collarbones, space between the eyebrows, space above the crown of the head. Then seeing your whole body. Your whole body like the landscape of that beautiful beach. And seeing your body mapped out in stones on the earth. Each stone nestled safely into the earth, held steadfast by the earth. And you come to imagine the stones a little more deeply, sensing the smooth parts of the stones, maybe against the rougher parts, and noticing any lighter colours or patterns on the stones. And then noticing any darker patterns or shapes on the stones. Becoming very interested in each individual stone and all of the stones together. And then as you gaze upon them, begin to feel the warmth of the sun It's just the right amount of sun and just the right temperature. You begin to feel the warmth of the sun on your body as if it was meeting the stones and the earth beneath them. And the whole body now feels a comfortable warmth from the sun, as if you were a warm stone, feeling the rays of the sun. The whole body radiating a comfortable warmth. And then imagining now a light rain, just the right size of raindrops, just the right pressure as they meet the stones, as if the stones were your body. Feeling the rain coming down on the landscape of your body that is the beach. Feeling the cool, refreshing rain moving over the landscape of your body and inviting a comfortable, refreshing coolness into the body now. And then imagining for a moment how it might be to feel the warmth of the sun and the cool, refreshing rain at the same time. How might that be? And then feeling a gentle wind moving over the landscape of your body, as if the wind was your breath, rolling free across the beach, rolling over the stones. Each stone held steadfast to the earth. And then one stone in particular now captures your attention and your imagination, and imagine that stone to be in the place of the heart. Come to gaze upon this beautiful stone nestled steadfast in the earth. And as you gaze upon the stone, a deep sense of peacefulness settles into you. And you know that no matter the weather, the rain, the sun, the wind, this sense of peacefulness remains steadfast, held by the earth. The sense of peacefulness remains in the heart. Everything else is just weather. And then imagine how amazing it would be for your whole body to feel and know that sense of peace. And know it to be true. And then becoming aware now of the weight of your body once again nestled on the ground. And feeling that each breath now is like a welcoming wind rolling across the landscape of your body, inviting you and drawing you back into a more wakeful state of being. Each breath in, quietly moving your awareness into a more everyday state, welcoming back the toes and the feet, welcoming back the legs and the hips, ready and willing to arrive in the now, in your body, present and aware to carry on with the rest of your day, awakening the fingers and the hands, awakening the arms and the shoulders, awakening the back, awakening the head, whole body in the present moment. Take a couple of deep, full breaths. And eventually a little movement into the body, and then bring in the knees and give yourself a lovely big hug as if you were meeting an old friend. And taking your time as you roll to the side before you eventually come up to sit. Now this practice of Yoga Nidra has come to an end. Hari Om Tat Sat.